Some people agree with, some disagree with, but that's the sport we have. Here we go, Megan Watson coming out representing Factory BJJ. She is known as the Gypsy Queen. This is her MMA debut. She's fighting out of Factory BJJ. Quite interesting fighting out of Factory BJJ, representing that team. So generally, just jiu-jitsu, when I say just, I'm not an insult, I'm a jiu-jitsu instructor. But what I mean is, by just the jiu-jitsu gym, they don't usually put out a huge amount of MMA fighters, tend to focus on the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. But Megan Watson coming out representing the Factory BJJ crew at Stockport under head coach black belt Adam Adshead and European Nogi champion himself. And it's so exciting watching debut fighters, because you always have the potential that this is the next great thing. This is the next Conor McGregor. This is the next Floyd Mayweather. This is the next John Jones. And we've had fighters that have entered this battle arena cage, being one of the premier amateur MMA promotions, that have gone on to fight in the UFC, in Bellator, and the biggest shows in the world, and be Cage Warriors champions and all the other shows that go with it. And we might see that very thing from Megan Watson. Is she the next great thing in MMA? We will find out tonight. She will be tested. And, you know, I've been in the cage myself. That debut, I mean, if you think going to a theme park and going on a roller coaster or bungee jumping is scary, you step into a cage with someone that's trained to hurt people. So no matter how this fight goes, you have to give huge respect to anyone making their debut. Huge respect to Megan Watson. Sophie Samantha coming out representing Manchester Predators. I'm pretty sure she's making a debut as well. Ooh, looks fired up, ready to go to Sophie Samantha. This is a featherweight bout in this 68 kilogram division. And she's the gym at Manchester Predators. Excellent gym. Very BJJ, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and kickboxing focused. And we know that the Manchester Predators always prepare their fighters really well. And I'm sure Sophie Samantha will be no exception. Remember, Battle Arena is brought to you by Subhology, Power Grip Sports, Direct Sport, Fisticuffs Podcast, excellent podcast, Eric's Fight Gear, the best mixed martial arts stuff you can wear. Oh, mean mugging early. Here we go, Sophie Samantha fired up. Oh, the tension. Carsten loves it. I let the tension build up, I think. Here we go. Here we go, Megan Watson, Sophie Samantha. Now all the mean mugging, all the psychological battles. None of that means anything as soon as the referee says go. Oh, loving the tension. Here we go, we have Megan, the Gypsy Queen Watson in the white top. And we have Sophie Samantha in the blue corner. Here we go. I love a bit of tension. Oh, big shots early.
There's no settling period there, was there?
No, and that's a front leg side kick. Oh, huge shots landed by both of them. They are trading. Rock'em sock'em robots. This is what we see with debuts, Carson. You're just so keen to get going. Oh, takedown, but is it wise to take down someone from Factory BJJ? We're going to see some beautiful jiu-jitsu off the back of Megan Watson. Or will we see Sophie Samantha ground and pound from the top? It's so different, Brazilian jiu-jitsu, when they're allowed to hit you in the face. Don't you think, Carsten?
It's a massive difference. I say this to all the BJJ guys at our place at Nottingham MMA. It's just a whole, it's a completely different sport. Massively, yep. Completely different.
I remember I was training with Roger Gracie, helping him get ready for some of his strike force fights. And he was said to me one day, he's like, the problem is only 20% of what I know works here. And I was like, that was a good, from the best grappler to ever do it. I thought it was an
interesting. And that's a guy that knows a hell of a lot. For him to say 20% works, that just shows you the difference that a punch in the face makes.
This is so true. Now, what we want to see from Sophie Samantha is that she improves position. She's looking for the ground and pound. She's got some good power, but Megan Watson getting back to her feet, or at least trying to. Oh, great hip pressure from Sophie Samantha. Good control.
Yeah, awesome hips and some great shots with that left hand. It's like a piston at the minute.
Yeah.
Really is. She's working really well up against the side of that cage.
But also, you know, with both fighters being debuted, with the nervous energy, everything else, you know, you don't want to punch yourself out too early. You want to pace yourself. Oh, look at the more of it.
Absolutely no pacing with these two girls.
Both of them down on the floor. Oh, double underhooks, looking for a trip. Beautiful takedown. And stepping straight over to half guard, stepping over that leg. Beautiful work. I know a lot of MMA fighters really rank half guard because it's a great position for holding down your opponent, Khabib style. Now, Steve, what does Megan Watson need to do from the bottom here to be able to get up? Steve. I called you Steve, Carsten.
You're so used to saying Steve. I can try and put an accent on if you want.
No, I hate his accent. Well, she's up now.
She's up.
Kicked her well on right hook. This is an insane fight. The pace.
This is an insane pace. Absolutely crazy pace going on right now.
Anyone watching this with the old school view goes, women should be doing MMA. Watch a fight like this. This is so entertaining. What an incredible sport.
I was absolutely literally going to say before this started, I love the women's fights because it's like they have a point to prove still, even though we know how good they are now. Yep. It's not 10 years ago when they had an actual point to prove and say they could fight. We know women can fight now, and this just shows it.
Well, I have a theory that the female fighters are tougher. I see the male fighters break. You see that point where they go, oh no, this guy's better than me. And they go, survival mode, maybe I'll give up my back, give up a choke. Female fighters, you never see that break. Never see them give up. It is just keep going to the end of the fight.
It's very, very rare that you do see a female fighter break. It just, if you watch the last UFC with Amanda Nunes and Juliana Pena, that just proves it, because that was such a great fight and Pena did not break one bit.
Yeah, zero quitting there. And then even Nunes was on crutches afterwards, right? What a fight. What amazing. I mean, the whole like MMA scene at the moment is incredible, from the very top to the very bottom. You know, the gyms are getting better, the levels are getting better. It's becoming such a mainstream sport. You know, in the US, it's on ESPN. In the UK, it's getting, you know, it's getting exposure on the BBC, Channel 5. It's becoming really mainstream, where when me and you were doing it back in the day, people were horrified if you told them what you did. Here we go, round two. Right. Megan Watson versus Sophie Samantha.
Let's see how much that first round took out of the girls. But they both look pretty fresh.
Oh yeah, there's still some meat mugging. Here we go.
Blowing kisses to each other, giving each other the stanky eye, and getting straight back to that action.
Yep, another takedown. Big activity levels from the bottom. Ground and pound, movement, angles. This is where Sophie Samantha needs to just pace herself a little bit. Look for a pass, get on top, hold her down. But when you're on top, you can hold the other person, let them waste a lot of energy. Just let them tire themselves out just for a minute, and then choose your moment, then pop to mount, throw up a submission, get that ground and pound going. But Megan Watson here needs to get her feet on the cage, bridge off the cage. It's one of the things a lot of jiu-jitsu gyms don't drill, is that cage work.
Yeah, and it's so important, especially obviously when the jiu-jitsu guys and girls cross over into MMA. They really should start doing a lot more work up against the cage.
Yeah, it's the extra element, and that's what we... Oh, she's back to her feet. Oh, reversed it. Oh, no, she's out. Samantha on top. Incredible.
What a scramble.
What athleticism from Megan, just reversing that position. She had her opponent's full body weight on her. Matched to drive, get up, win the scramble. What kind of judo headlock? Oh, reversal again.
Oh, she's got that Khabib as well. She's got the left arm laced through, holding the left arm, and now ground and pounding with that right arm. This is was a great position.
Yeah, but she got mount. I mean, lost the grip Megan and went straight to mount.
Yeah.
Look at that. Oh, huge shot.
My God, this is monstrous ground and pound.
Beautiful. Oh, throw the legs up.
They're right in front of us, and the sound of this is crazy.
And still over a minute left in the round. Megan Watson's going to have to find a way out.
She needs to get them hands on the hips, get a little bit lower down so she can use the hips to push her off. She's a little bit high at the moment for her to use her hips to push.
Oh, trying to trap the arm. Very good work there. Yeah, like you say, Carsten, yeah, just a little bit low. Needs to wiggle up, use that cage maybe, push off there with her feet. She gives it a go, not a bad effort. Thing is, in normal jiu-jitsu, you kind of push them down your body using your elbows, but then you're more vulnerable to ground and pound.
That's it, yeah.
Oh, doing everything she can to try and get out of this position. There is no quit in Megan Watson. And it's almost like Sophie Samantha is punching herself out, even though she's top of mount, exhausting herself, trying to put away Megan Watson.
She's going to have to take a 30-second little break right now. I think that's what she's doing. Yep. She's staying nice and heavy. She's still got the position. But she took a little break and now she's back to the ground and pound. This is a great fight.
I suppose, you know, there's now 10 seconds left in the round. What I like to do when I'm cornering someone, I won't shout, you know, go for an armbar or whatever, until there's that kind of 20 seconds. I'm like, she's won the round. Let's take a risk. We might lose the position, but it'll be so short time, there's no risk. Wow.
So I just want to ask you a question. Oh. With a round like that, how would you score it? Is that a 10-8 or a 10-9?
Well, I was talking between rounds, between fights, Carsten, about the scoring system. I don't understand. At the very least, we have 10 points. Why don't we use all 10?
Yeah.
Why can't we have 10 fives, 10 fours, 10 threes? Like, it doesn't make any sense to me that it's either a 10-9 or a 10-8. There's, you know, that's quite tough to call that round a 10-8, but it's also not a 10-9 by normal standards.
Yeah.
So it's like, let's have a 10-8.5. And like, we need an easier way. We need to completely revamp the scoring system in MMA. We've stolen the system from boxing where you have 12 rounds.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's not so important if one round is misscored in boxing. Yeah. In MMA, it's everything. We've got three rounds to choose from. And I think 10-8s, 10-7 should be given much faster. And I think if someone has mount, lands loads of shots like that, that should be a 10-8.
Yeah, I would have thought that would be a 10-8 for me. Yeah. She controlled the majority of the round and had some big, big ground and pound.
Yeah. Wow. What an... Already, we're two fights in here at Stoke, and it's incredible. Absolutely brilliant. Oh, front kick up the middle to open. Oh, a little less pace. I talked about maybe that Sophie Samantha punched herself out in that ground and pound position. She's looking more fatigued now.
Yeah, she's definitely looking a lot more laboured now. That she definitely took a little 30 seconds where she had a little breather and she needed it. And now I don't know if that 1 minute has done her enough to get the energy back.
Or maybe Megan's, desperation because she's like, I can't finish this girl.
Yeah, maybe. She gave her best and now she didn't finish her. And she still stood there in front of her and still hitting her.
And then also, you know, most likely two rounds up with that 10-8, possible 10-8 as well. She knows she's got to get through this round. Oh. I think it was a...
And that was a groin shot.
So with a groin shot, that's an illegal strike in mixed martial arts. So usually given up to 5 minutes to recover. You can almost be strategic here, could Sophie Samantha, because she is a bit fatigued. Could have milked it a little bit, but she chose not to. Oh, just walking forward now, but gets the takedown. This is what she wants. She's clearly more tired. Get the takedown, hold her down, win this round, or get through this round, win the fight. And Megan Watson needs to do everything she can to try and get back to her feet, throw some submissions up off her back, but it's so hard when your head is against the cage. You just can't angle off. That's the problem, isn't it, Carsten?
Definitely, and especially now as well. You know, we're into the third round. They're both very sweaty, very slippery. So catching a submission now is going to be a lot harder than it was in the first round. Oh,
kicks her away, comes on top. She wants to finish this, Carsten. She knows she's got 90 seconds. She's two rounds down. Go for broke. Come on, Megan Watson. That's my non-biased.
That's your non-biased shout. I would like to see her just push away, get up and make Sophie get back up.
You're completely right then, Carsten, because she didn't do that, it gave Sophie the opportunity to turn in and get back on top.
And as much as Megan is still trying to work from the bottom, still trying to land shots, she's just trying to land knees to the ribs there, but this isn't going to win her a round. It isn't going to win the fight. I think she needs a finish.
Something's happened.
I'm not quite sure what happened
But some kind of illegal incident.
Yeah. Referee Paul Nichols is one of the best in the business here, so he knows what he's talking about, and he's got these girls well looked after.
I mean, me and you couldn't see from the angle we're at, Carsten, but I mean, up against the cage, grabbing gloves is common. Grabbing the cage to stop the other person get up, quite a common one as well. Probably one of those infractions. And this is referee Paul Nichols. I mean, he's worked on some of the biggest shows in the world. If you have anyone refereeing, you want it to be him. You know, he's calm, controlled, collected, and he's one of these referees that was willing to discipline a fighter when they need it. Here we go. So, 48 seconds.
Not sure what happened, but they both start back up on the feet, which is great for Megan. But Sophie's working really hard for this takedown again. She knows where she wants to put it. She wants to put it back on the floor.
Grabbing the cage. Guillotine. Arm in, guillotine.
It's a one-handed guillotine at the moment.
I'm pretty sure it's illegal, but I like it. Reverse kind of hook kick to the thigh.
I mean, it's a legal shot when it is to the thigh, but when she hit the back in the spine area, then that turns into an illegal shot.
Yeah, so our viewers at home, you can't hit the spine, essentially. So you can hit you can do that kind of weird hook kick to the glutes, to the thigh, just not to the middle. What a fight. What a fight. Incredible.
Two fights in, and both of them were unbelievable so far. I don't know who I would choose for fight of the night.
It's already going to be a tough one. Incredible. Wow. I don't think I don't think these guys are going to be friends after that fight. I think Megan Watson and Sophie Samantha. Maybe we need a rematch. That could be the move. Let's let them do it again. I could watch that for 10 more rounds. Absolutely incredible. Absolutely incredible. What a way to kick off the evening here. Battle Arena Stoke, two live wire fights.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, put your hands together. What a great contest. That's two fights in, and both of them have absolutely incredible so far. The guys in the field, like I said, have got a lot to look to so far. So, after three rounds of action, the judges and scoreboards for the decision. And all three judges have it as a unanimous decision for the fighter in the blue corner, Samantha. And please, Mr. Royce, go for it, Megan Watson.
What an incredible fight that was. Absolute barn burner. And, you know, debut, getting so much experience. Both these guys, so much cage time right there. So many things to learn from. So many little adaptations. The coaches can watch this video back. They're probably watching it right now, actually, as I say this. You can hear my voice. watching it back on YouTube, and some of the highlights as well. Look at these shots. Boom, and the takedowns, the constant takedown pressure from Sophie Samantha. That was the thing that made the difference. Just pressure, 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 pressure. Hopefully get a rematch. I'd like to see a rematch. Let's get Megan Watson drilling to off her back, working on some sweeps, practicing that sprawl, and let's go again.